Thank you. Society, the mighty Kimball Theater Pipeworks, and the fourth largest of its kind in the world. Rousing applause for everyone. I'm Dave, the president of Dickinson, and it's indeed my pleasure to welcome all of you here. Thanks for being with us tonight. We'd love to have many more of you, so please help spread the word about this great instrument. Welcome to our season ticket holders, welcome to our donors, thank you for your unwavering support of Dickinson Theater Society. Welcome again to the special group that's here from Ware Presbyterian. You know what, we have several retirement communities that come to our show, and I'm just going to give a shout out to all of them and say thank you for coming to all of our shows. Before I introduce our artists for the evening, I wanted to welcome all our newcomers who are here with us for the first time tonight. Thanks for being here. I welcome you to come back. We have one more show remaining in this, our 29th season. I call your attention in your playbill. There's a yellow survey. You can take some time throughout the evening tonight, fill this out for the intermission. You can put it up here in the blue box or out in the lobby. Well, it's that time again when we'll be sending our mailing on our annual appeal. Thanks to those of you who have given so generously in the past, and now more than ever, we need your support to this important time. The income we receive from ticket sales alone does not cover the costs of these concerts, so it's gifts like yours for our annual appeal that help keep our ticket prices low and provide for the continuous upkeep of this tremendous instrument. As we celebrate our 50th anniversary of the 50th season next year, we're pulling out all the stops, literally, and the quality and quantity of the entertainment that you will be provided with next season will far exceed, the expenses will far exceed the revenue that we'll generate from ticket sales, I assure you. Speaking of our 50th season, if you're not on our mailing list, then you know nothing about it. You need to get on our mailing list. There's forms up here you can put in the blue bucket. You can choose to get a paper mailed to you, the US mail, or electronic. Either way, in order to get a copy, you have to be on our list. So please take care of that at intermission. I have a special announcement from our friends at the Theater Organ Society of Delaware Valley in Phoenixville. They have a concert tomorrow at 2 o'clock featuring Johnny End. So please note that and join them there. During intermission, be sure to stop by our music shop and browse through various CDs, DVDs, and merchandise that's available for purchase, and items from our artists tonight will be featured out there for sale as well. Now, speaking of our artists, the most played world supermarket in the world is located in the Blackpool Tower Hall Room in Blackpool, England, and tonight's featured artist is the principal resident organist there. In his 45th year, yes, he started when in diapers. The demand for Kimball Kelsall on the concert circuit in the UK and the USA is completely overwhelming. Winner of numerous prestigious awards, which you can read about all in your playbill, Phil is also one of the most recorded organists in the world, with over 40 albums credited to his name and numerous radio and television credits as well. People come from all over to see Phil. In fact, Her Royal Highness herself, the Queen of England, came to see Phil at the Tower Ballroom, and we saved some seats up here just in case she might show up here tonight. Tonight, in his debut appearance with us here at Dickinson, he is considered to be one of the best among theater organists, and we have him here with us. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Dickinson Theater, Phil Kelsall.
Thank you. door tonight. So thank you very much for those very kind words. It is a great pleasure to be here playing this delightful Kimball Theatre organ. I've heard so much about it, and indeed when I mentioned I'm playing the Kimball to my colleagues, and my colleagues are the most finest theatre organists in the world, Richard Hills and Simon Glenville, they say, "This is my favourite organ in the whole world." So what better compliment could you have? So you must be very proud of this instrument here at Dickinson. I'm going to enjoy playing it. Now, the style of the music tonight is probably something you're not quite used to. We don't have any lush chords and American harmonies, but it's called the Blackpool style because it's based on playing the theatre organ as a compass set for dancing at Blackpool Tower. The organ has played at Blackpool Tower for 85 years, and it's a very popular set up there, and the organ's played every day, summer and winter, for about 4 or 5 hours every day. So it's quite an ordeal for the poor organ. I'll tell you more about Blackpool as the show goes on, but I'm going to start in traditional English theatre organ style with a few marches. Thank you very much. Thank you. Some wonderful American music there, the last tune, last Sunday, by the longest of them all, everything about it. I hope you enjoyed those tunes. Right, well, a little bit warm tonight. Last night, beer leading out, obviously. So, I'm just going to finish off this first section with a few more, I call them kind of novelty tunes, call them what you will. I'm just going to try and demonstrate a few more of the lovely tonal traps and the non-tonal traps we have on this instrument, the xylophone, piano you've heard, glockenspiel, and some lovely vibraphone crystal type sounds. So here we go, I've done a little melody for you, and after this we'll have a break, and I'll have a cold shower or something, and we'll come back and do some. Okay, thank you very much. Here's the first one, it's going to feature the grand piano over there. It's a pretty tune, again, by American composer Leroy Anderson, Forgotten Dreams.
Thank you.
not an incredible first half?
Thank you to our volunteers and those who donated treats to make this happen for us.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the bench, Phil Kelsall.
Thank you.
sing and dance, as you've never heard it before. How long have I been with you doing a rest? You're a sponsor of those things. And I'm going to finish off this concert with some music which you definitely probably won't hear over in the States. And this is the third organ played in the style of ballroom dancing. So I'm sure many of you have done the old foxtrot now again, quick step, the waltz. It's a shame we don't have a little dance floor here, because you could get up and have a little jig round by all means. But here we go then, this is the story of Blackpool. Blackpool Tower, of course, was modeled on the Eiffel Tower in Paris. A group of Blackpool businessmen went over to Paris for a business convention, I suppose you call it now. And they saw the Eiffel Tower and thought, we'd have one of those at Blackpool. So they came home, raised money, and built the tower. This is 500 feet, whereas the Eiffel Tower is 1,500 feet, so quite a little bit smaller. But the big difference is, as you know, those of you who've been to Paris, isn't that awful? That Notre Dame thing, the fire there, that's awful. But the good news is, the organ is totally safe, very, very fortunate. The organ is at the west end of the cathedral, and as you know, the bulk of the fire was at the east end, where the altar is. So the organ is safe. While I'm telling this, oh yes, the Blackpool Tower has a big set of buildings beneath the structure of the tower, whereas, of course, you can walk underneath the Eiffel Tower, there's nothing underneath it. So the businessman thought they could make some money from this tower by having a set of entertainment complexes beneath it. So there is, in fact, circus ring and all sorts of restaurants and bars, and of course there's the Tower Ballroom, which was beneath the tower. And it's better for the festival, and of course in the older days, 1920s, before these instruments were invented, the means of entertainment in the ballroom was like a 15-piece orchestra playing for dancing. Then the workers came along and the management thought, well, we could get an organ and we only have to pay one man instead of 50 musicians. So that was a very clever little move for the tower. And of course, the organ still there to this day. It's the same instrument designed in 1930 by an organist who was a household name in the UK. And his name was Reginald Dix. And as I say, no one had ever attempted to play the organ for dancing before, certainly not a huge instrument like this. And they had a few people at the tower before Reg arrived. And one of them was in the stuff called the Royal College of August, can't get any better. But of course, that doesn't mean anything when in the world of entertainment. And they played the dancing and they were totally hopeless. They couldn't keep time and people were falling over and all sorts of things. So they were got rid of. And Reg was next to audition in 1929. And they asked him, had he played for dancing before? And he told them a lie. He said, yes, I've played for dancing before. He had, in fact, played for one dance, and he was sent home being useless as well. So, here we go, this is the story. And it's Reg, of course, started his season in 1930, and he became so popular with all the holidaymakers, he actually nailed the style of playing for dancing, which is what you've kind of heard this evening, really, loosely. But this time we're going to play really strict tempo, so no speeding up, no slowdown, no rubato. And this is how it actually happens in the tower if you were to visit. It's only 7 hours across the Atlantic, and you'll be there in no time. It's a wonderful ballroom, I would say, and when I go home, I'm playing for a very special party in the tower room, and it's this year 125 years old. So we're quite an event, looking forward to that. So here we go then, a little bit of dance music for you. And the most popular tune we get asked every day is the wedding anniversary waltz. So lots of people met at the ballroom in the war years, 1930s, 1940s, and they come back every year, you know, for their anniversary, which is what they come and tell us. And we play it for them, and they get a bit of dance. So here we go, the anniversary waltz.
Thank you. Condition. So I think we should give them a collective round of applause.
thank you for your support tonight. Thank you for turning up. I do have a very safe journey. I'll be careful on the way home. It's dark outside. I'm off up to Boston to play next week. This time next week, I should be playing in Boston, in Massachusetts. So I don't think I'll see. I think there are a few of you here tonight from Boston. So I look forward to seeing you. Have to do it all again next week. One time. So there we go. That's it for tonight. Thanks to everyone, and thanks to everyone here, David, our compound chairman. Thank you very much for being here.